Greetings, and welcome back to some more Battle Brothers. We are about to join a war camp for House Hedin over here. We'll be taking part in a great battle against House Horn over here. House Horn. They're kind of mad at us. These guys didn't care that we took a side in a war, but the other ones are livid. We're going to be paid 3,450 crowns for a two-skull contract in the Noble War. We currently have an ambition to end said Noble War. They should make us friendly with them, hopefully. Let's go see. In this army camp, what do you want us to do? Arriving at Sir Steinhardt's war camp, you find the men cheering on a barely dressed woman riding around in a donkey. The lady and the ass ride off into a tent which quickly swells with men. Firefan the wolf asks if he can go. You state that you're going too, so yes, of course. Just then, Sir Steinhardt grabs you. He leads you to his command tent. Trust me, you don't want to see that. You don't trust him. What do you need the Eagles of Fortune to do, sir? He explains the situation. A few of my pathfinders have located some of House Horn's scouts just southwest of here. They're rummaging around looking for the main army. But they won't find it, because you're gonna go out there and kill them all. Got it? Sure, we'll head out immediately. Intercept scouts, leave no one alive. Rather, let no one leave alive. Sure thing, Mr. Boss Man! Casimir, you've got yourself an injured kneecap. That's a problem. Neil's got a pierced hand. I'm thinking we might switch in Steiner instead. Just because I can't afford a mobility injury. BVS, you have a pierced hand as well. I'm probably going to leave you out of this then. I'm going to cut Achilles tendon. Oh, that's bad. A lot of injuries. And Neil's wound is infected. Good! That's just what we needed. Minus 25 hit points and minus 25 fatigue. That's going to put Neil on the back burner. So we've got these scouts running over here. There's 10 of them. Some footmen, a few billmen, one arbalester, and a few war dogs from House Horn. Can we stall this any longer? I think we can. Okay, good. Just want to see if we can maybe cure some wounds. Gerhard's looking better today. We did give him a badass shield that we got last episode. 28 melee defense. So he gets like, I don't know, you give a bonus of 25. We're nearly getting 7 from this, so it's probably rounded down to 6. He's got 53 melee defense, he's pretty good. That said, the maximum fatigue on that is ridiculous. Might have to switch it over to someone like Roderick at some point. Because Roderick would also really benefit from it. You know what, I think that's a better call. Roderick has the fatigue to wield it properly. You know, Gerhard still has 43. He's still good, don't get me wrong. But Roderick, he's gonna be tanking a lot better. So there we go. He's also got, you know, 3 stars in melee defense, which is rather ranged defense. So it's gonna be easier for him to compensate for that shield. Oh yes, they are definitely aggro. Cool. We can lead them on for a while, but I think we're just gonna have to bite down and fight them. Yep, they're coming towards us, alright. So there's 10 of them, but 3 dogs. Right, this is... Oh, it's the same music as fighting mercenaries, I approve. I'm gonna firefan hold. They've got 2 billmen, okay. I'm sorry, dogs! This is so confusing. Okay, that explains it a little bit. Tell you to hold for now. Gunnar, I'm incredibly sorry. I don't like telling you to do this, but it has to be done. Our men are in a rather sorry shape for what we're about to try and do. Sorry! I don't like this either! Not happy at all. Right, Roderick, if anyone can do this, it's you. Stop making me feel bad, game! You're making me feel bad. Let's get you over there, yeah. Oh, there's a bush over there, interesting. That arbalest is slightly worrying, yep. Tell Firefan to hold. Tell you to hold as well, Balon. Tell you to hold. That was too many actions. Gonna stab in on him, excellent. He's gonna come up and charge us, which is fine. Tell you to hold. Well, Roderick takes a hit, but it's fine. I think we're just gonna charge. I want Gerhard in there. I want... Do I go for Broke? It would be risky, but then again... Yeah, just go over there. That's gonna be safer. Otherwise, the other Billman is also gonna be able to jab you from quite far. That guy is looking like he's gonna get murdered soon. I'm gonna tell Brad to hold as well. I want... Oh, Firefan already took a move. Sadly, Firefan is not gonna be able to get a nice stab off of this turn. Balon isn't either. That's okay. Diner, just get around there if you can. Gunnar is going to be able to start hammering next turn. Got a 49 on that one, but it misses, sadly. We'll try and creep around. That arbalest needs to die. He's looking rather smug with his grin there. Get a jab into that one. He's now running. As well he should. That guy's gonna get very overwhelmed very quickly. We stab him with a 5% chance to hit. Just look at that. Let's get Gunnar up there then. You can get around over there. Leave him a route to flee. Give that guy a bit of a stab. Do I rotate Gunnar? No. Erlen, just stay there. Hold it. He gets another stab into him. That's really bad for him. They're starting to get a bit demoralized. I wonder why. These are the so-called noble houses, eh? Those which rule the lands with impunity. Not impressed. Not one bit. Firefan just cuts him down. No nonsense, just... Heads rolling! Quite literally. My oh my, do I approve of this. Form a nice roly-poly over there. You can hold. Charge you, maybe. Figure we are better off trying to murder those guys, though. He's gonna start running. Right, we need to leave no one alive. That's a big thing here. That's one of our objectives. Thankfully, we can catch that sucker. And we caught the runny one as well. They tend to turn tail and run as soon as things don't go their way. Overwhelm might have possibly saved our life there. I will choose to believe that it did. Nice try. But, it won't save you now. Get over there, he's gonna start pooping himself soon. As he should. Deflect that, so we took a bit of damage, but honestly, not nearly as much as I was afraid of. Especially considering the sorry state we entered this battle in. You'd be exhausted, that's fair enough. The arbalest that goes down, we actually get ourselves a heavy crossbow. Holy hell. I know someone who's going to be dying to use that. Oh, of course we're running this guy down. Who do you think we are? We're being paid for our job, sir. We will accomplish said job. It's always better when enemy scouts don't return, after all. He tried. Our turn. He's a brave, foolish man. Yeah, we were fighting with a man down there, that makes sense. But we get all their shields. They're fancy shields, I give them that. We also get a bunch of bill hooks. Now we're gonna start making some money, gentlemen. Achievement unlocked. Not so noble. All the scouts have been slain. Whatever information they had died with them. This will be a great boon for the upcoming battle. And we get to report. That should get us 3,400 crowns. Making it rain. The war camp is just as you left it. You're not sure if that's good or bad. Tomorrow we'll bring more shite to take care of, so you order the Eagles of Fortune to get some rest. Rest well! We'll soon be called upon again. What, we're not getting paid yet? Guys, I think we should desert! Nah, it's fine. Balon, level 4, congratulations. We'll give you a bit of ranged defense, we'll give you some resolve. Maybe a bit of health? Health would probably be good. Yeah, a bit of extra health. Your health is not very good, is it? Even with Colossus. We'll probably give you Brawny for more fatigue, or Rotation. Rotation's probably better. Erland! Melee skill, excellent. Melee defense as well. Maybe a bit of resolve. Make sure he doesn't run away. Do we specialize you? Do we give you Battle Forged? I think that might be a bit of an overextension. I don't know if this applies for you. We'll see. But I won't do that yet. I think we should maybe... Like, Polar Mastery doesn't feel that useful. You only take one action, and that's 15 fatigue. Now, you could say that, you know, if we do take that stab, and we move a little, we might still build up fatigue. Which would be valid, but I'd rather spend stuff in other places. To make sure they do more damage, for example. Maybe reach advantage? I mean, you do have a two-handed melee weapon. You're only ever gonna get one hit. So that's only gonna give you like 20% melee defense. You're not meant to be in the line. I think we'll go Overwhelm on you, just because I really started to like Overwhelm. Well, you know what? Let's at least camp up here then. This is a war camp after all. Might as well camp towards it. Bit of a shame though that we're not getting paid for that immediately. Oh dear. Outside your tent, a rooster loudly lets everyone know what a real asshole of an animal it is! You begrudgingly get up. A young boy stands outside your tent with a scroll. He unfurls and struggles to read it.
Your commander has requested,
You just better go and see him yourself. He has requested our presence. Time to pay a visit to the commander. You found Sir Steinhardt brooding over his maps. His knuckles turn into his table. The legs groaning and wobbling. He looks up. His eyes flash. A quick glance of unbelievable anger. A few of my men saw fit to desert my army. The sentries tell me they saw them running west of here. Go and bring them back. You ask if he wants them alive. He nods. I want them back healthy as they can. As healthy as can be, so I can better remind them what it means to abandon my army. Of course, if they absolutely refuse, then I want them dead. That's also a good reminder to not abandon the army, wouldn't you agree? The company will head out within the hour. Either convince them to go back, or kill them. Alright. We'll try our best, sir. You better be paying extra for this. Then again, I guess this is a large contract, so... Eh. How are we doing on injuries, by the way? Men are mostly healed in the line, although Gunnar's injured. Injuries over there and stuff. It's not good. Hello, deserters. Some footmen, a few billmen, a few arbalesters. Speaking of arbalesters... BVS, where are you? You're the one specialized in crossbows. That's 10 extra damage, 5% more effectiveness against armor. Sweet. It was free as well. There's also a bunch of bill hooks that I'm definitely gonna be hanging on to. And some shields. Like, I don't really care about their shields. Deserters, how are we gonna do this? We can... just talk to them, I guess. James points out a group of men standing at a road sign. They're arguing loudly amongst themselves to hear your approach. Oh, arguing too loudly to hear your approach. You give a sharp whistle, which simultaneously silences and spins the men around. One rears back. Well, the Red Commander sent mercenaries after us. You nod and explain that they should come on back with you. Another deserter shakes his head. Go on back? How about you go on and get the hell out of here? We ain't going back just so you can go on and just tell the commander that. Is this who you want to be? Commanders, cowards that won't defend their own lands? As the deserters turn to leave, Balon the Kennelmaster steps forward and clears his throat. So that's how it's going to be, huh? You're just gonna wiggle out of your responsibilities like a bunch of limp dicks. I know how you're feeling. I know you see no point in this war or risking your life for some stuck-up nobleman who has no idea what you're going through. That's fair. But you're gonna wake up years from now, bouncing your grandson on your knee, and he's gonna ask you questions about when you fought in the war. You're gonna have to lie to that little boy. The leader politely refuses to come back. We didn't choose this path lightly, sellsword. We're not coming back. You order the Eagles of Fortune to draw out their weapons. The deserter's leader sighs, but nods understandingly. I suppose it is what it is. We talked of this. We are prepared to die here. Walking where we wish, rather than die out here, out there on some dog's orders. This is all the world to us now. Shrugging, you respond. It's only business for us. Let's get this over with. Alright, Fire Fan, you know what needs to happen. They made their choice. I will not mourn people who made... Well, they made their choice, right? They had a choice. And they picked. It is not our fault for what happens next. no matter what. That is something we need to remember. You know, it's their choice. If they didn't want to fight, then, well, we kind of forced them anyway. For a different reason. He did pick a bloody good position, though, I'll give him that. Fire Fan is going to be at a disadvantage up there, but then again, it's Fire Fan. I don't think he cares too much. I need Magnus in the... I need Roderick in there, sorry. Must be the Arbalesters. Fire Fan is going to do what Fire Fan does. Build up a bunch of reach advantage. Which would actually mean that he is going to be the safest person there. There's a tree there, there's a boulder there, so there's only one person that can go there. I will go and try and murder him. We'll then rotate in Roderick. You get to, you know, split his nose a little. You can try and help out against him for a second. Steiner's gonna just hold there. You're gonna hold there. We do have someone coming over in from the north there. Fire Fan is able to deflect. Magnus gets the kill, which means Roderick can push up and stab him in the face. Get a bit of an overwhelm penalty on him as well. Looks like we've got two brave souls over here. Overwhelm might have helped us out by a bunch there. Fire Fan misses, which is not good. You don't want Fire Fan to miss that. Pretty sure we're not getting paid to kill them all, so if we don't have to kill them all, that would be great. The other side of the coin, we can get those fancy shields. Fire Fan's luck holds out, however. We're just gonna hold there. Like, if he decides to charge us, sure. Feel free, you know? Their arbalests are pretty much out of play at the moment, which is fantastic. I'm sorry to say that Fire Fan just claimed the life of another deserter. I'm only sorry because they're bloody idiots. This is not how I wish to have earned my, you know, my fame. By besting some deserters in battle. I have to be honest about that. There's no glory to be had here. Just slaughter. Right, we have him 3-1. That guy's gonna be looking mighty dead soon as well. If we're lucky. Their arbalesters are still out of play. I don't know where. I don't think I really care either. Super Sarge is going to break through any minute now. Or rather, Fire Fan. They might think they have him outnumbered. But really, they're making the odds fair. Bless you, Fire Fan. You awesome warrior. Let's try and put this guy down. Stop resisting. Stop trying to make it harder for yourself. Oh, you're actually... Oh. I was like, oh yeah, you can hold that pass. It'll be great. What could possibly go wrong? Oh, there's nothing there to defend. I'll hold you for now. They might come towards us. You know, make our life easier. Try and get some more swings into that guy. But it's just not happening. Good lord. Roderick's able to hold that corner down easy enough. Start overwhelming him a little. There we go. We are making things happen slowly. Fire Fan. 69, 45. We'll go for the 69. Cut his arm, so he's gonna do less damage, I believe. Or, you know, just lose his head. It's a bit morbid, but it works. It's gonna dissuade them from walking away from an army ever again, mostly because they won't be able to do any walking anymore. It's a sad tale, really. Yeah, he is not gonna mess with Fire Fan. Let's just do what has to be done, alright? Again, there's no glory to be had here. Just a job to be done. They're gonna start taking shots at you now, probably. Or running. Or both. It's a damn shame. Now, these men could have been my brother. If we were raised in another city or another country, you know. Again, there's no honor to be had here. There's no glory on this battlefield. It's just death. Now, you could say the same of most battlefields, but I'd argue that this one is a bit special. So we're fighting our supposed allies who ran. I don't think you'll want to go over there, just trust me on that. If you run to survive, you're running in the wrong bloody direction, mate. Perform some roly-polies and there we go. He has just basically trapped himself there. It's a sad story, but that is how this will end. Sadness. I think he's trying to run. Because we just stabbed him for free. You are now trapped, Mr. Arbalester. Sorry. He might actually get away. The one survivor. Firefan just up and murdered him. Which is an average day for Firefan. Yeah, that guy's gonna run. He's gonna get away. Bless him. I'll let the dog out, don't get me wrong. He might actually catch him. That's almost sad. Oh well. You know, they made a choice. It's not my mistake. Run him down. And he did not get away. He died trying to run back or something. I don't know. We did, in the end, catch them all. Which I guess will make our employer happy at least, because we, you know, we dissuaded anyone else from running. But at what cost? At what cost, I ask you? He's just gonna try to run. He's not even putting up a fight. Does he even have a backup weapon? It matters little now, I guess. Ike and Steiner go level up. We leave a nasal helm? I think we'll leave a dagger. Or something else terrible, like, maybe one medical supply? Like, we've got plenty of medical supplies. Yeah. Roderick the Militiaman cleans his blade on the tabard of one of the corpses. It's a shame they went out of that way. They could have lived. They had a choice. You shrug and respond. They had death on all sides of them. They merely chose us as the executioners. It's a sad tale, really. We'll leave the dire wolves be. We're just gonna report and then we're gonna sell stuff. Ike, congratulations, you went level up. 3-3, and maybe fatigue? Yeah, probably fatigue. And you could also use a bit of health. We'll go fatigue. They're on 41 at the moment. But that's because of her injury. As for skills, you are already battle force. I'm gonna go overwhelm. It really saved the day there, in my opinion. As for Steiner, 2 melee skill. We'll work on your resolve a little bit, and a bit more fatigue as well. We'll probably go overwhelm. Yeah, that's good. Still got some injuries in the line. We'll try to deal with that. We desperately have to sell stuff now, though, because things are getting expensive to run. Good lord, man! Sir Steinhardt nods to your report, but is otherwise not really paying any attention to you. A bunch of battle maps are laid out on the table. His eyes are focused on those instead. You understand it. Tomorrow is the big battle, and he has better things to think about. You decide to turn in for the night. Rest well this night, men. For tomorrow, battle awaits. But first, let's bring some stuff to the merchants. They should be happy to see us. Got plenty of food, plenty of tools. We are able to sneak in there just in time. Stuff is expensive, as it always is. Right, sword. I'm gonna sell all the shields that do not look like the right house, because, well, screw you. Those are good hats! Very good hats, in fact, wow! Sell the crappy ones, yes! Now let's talk weapons. We'll sell the most damaged pikes, we'll sell the crossbows. We'll sell some of the morning stars. Most of them are heavily damaged anyway. Sell some of the military picks. Sure, we'll keep one. We do have a bunch of warhammers now as well. Sell the falchions and the daggers. Now have a bunch of extra kite shields, which, you know, they're painted in the noble house's colors. I think I'll sell this one, because I kind of like the sun one, I'll be honest. Very vain, I know. Down to 59. This basic mail shirt is a basic mail shirt, it's not going to be that great. We are back up to 13,000 rounds, which is good. Could buy the closed mail coif for 90 armor. Not bad. Let's start fitting our people with some better stuff. We actually have better hats in these bassinets for some of our people, which is ironic. This one is really damaged, but it's, you know, really good. Only thing it does is take away 2 fatigue. I think I'll give it to Roderick. It's gonna get him up to 230 armor on his head. You're gonna keep the brain matter safe, you know. He needs that to think. I think we'll give it to Magnus. You've got battle forged, so yeah. 40 extra armor. Sure, that works. I also really like the look of the bassinet, I'll be honest. I think we could sell this closed flat top helmet, because the other guy's just way better. Sure, it's like 3 extra fatigue, but so good. Hell, this one is even worse, but it's got way less fatigue, so I'm probably gonna delegate that to Super Sarge later. Enjoy it while you can, Fire Fan. Enjoy it while you can. Well, that's the last of our better helmets, isn't it? No, we've got one more, but it's really damaged. I'll give it to, name Gunnar. You deserve a better helmet. There you go, buddy. We'll give the other badass closed flat top helmet to Erland, because I like the look of it. I'll give you the 151, I guess. We could sell all of these. Want to keep onto the mail cloth just in case? Yeah, sure, why not? You've got 140 as well. We've got 140, that's slightly better. It's like one more vision and one more fatigue. You know, it's something. It's petty, but you know, it's something. We'll get Super Sarge in the line. He knows what to do with a bow. Did I accidentally sell the backup hunting bow I had? I think I did. Sorry, baby. Sorry, Bertram, I mean. BBS is the crossbow. My god, is it awesome. You know, we'll double up on our back line a bit. Sweet. We're gonna have a big battle tomorrow. Thankfully, we have a lot of people, so, you know, we can somewhat compensate. Gunnar, I really should pull you out, but then... You're still quite good. Well, I should put James back in. And we could pull out Neil, but then again, we'd have Bertram. Which is not bad, don't get me wrong. That's not to say Bertram isn't good at his job. We kinda don't have a bow for him anymore. That's a problem. But you know, it's better than having injured people in the battle line. This is getting close, I'll be honest. I'm very excited to see what this battle is about. It should earn us a ton of rep if the game is nice to us. Which it probably won't, but you know. We'll give it a damn good try at least. We'll sell one pike. Yeah, we'll sell one pike, why not? Also, amber shards. Those are useful. We're starting to run our medical supplies a bit lower, good lord. Oh, we should sell these nasal helmets. They're rusty. 14,000 crowns! We're getting paid in equipment, that's for sure. Like, we got ourselves invaluable helmets. They're gonna keep our men alive. Like, seriously, that saved us like 6,000 crowns or something by just killing them all. It's a rather grim fate, I'll agree with you on that, but... It's better! You know? Why let some deserters or scouts carry it when we should obviously carry it around? 15 hours to fix everything. Ah, Sir Steinhardt addresses his men with a deep, strong tone. Ah, some of you are looking very giddy. Can't wait to slaughter Househorn's men, huh? I know that feeling. A scattering of nervous laughter. The commander continues. Keep your families in mind, men, for they are surely depending upon us this day. Onwards, brothers. I hear there's a battle to win. Ugh! Lots of footmen, many billmen, some arbalesters, a few standard bearers. There's a sergeant, a few knights, and some war dogs. To arms! Wow. It's one hell of a battle size, isn't it? 50 men. Good lord. We seem to be positioned right into the middle of it. Because of course we are. In their defense, that does make complete sense. You would want to trust the less, you know... If you don't trust someone, put them in the middle of your formation. They won't run. They'll fight no matter what, because otherwise they'll die. Which is pretty much what they're gonna do to us if we don't make it out. It's gonna be a fair share of the booty, though, if we do get out alive. This guy's dead. Sir Eckhart's looking good. Sir Steinhardt! Ooh. You are quite liberally praising the sun over there. I approve. Well, they're gonna be charging in. Hopefully Firefan will get some extra surrounding bonuses from that and just murder him straight up. If someone could stand behind him, that would be even better. Let's try and hit the standard bearer, which we don't. Oh well. Hello. You were not what I was hoping for, I'll be honest. All of our men seem very slow. Or just not eager to join the battle, whichever one of that they may choose. Like, I'd like Gerhardt to move so we could get over there. I'd like people to stand over there, maybe, although it's a very risky position to stand. I'll send Steinert over there. He should be able to help out without dying. One thing must be said, this is a massive battle. I think Gerhardt can take this. Sir Eckhart's gonna be moving next, interesting. Oh, he's coming right towards us as well. Bloody bugger. God, there's gonna be so many billmen over there. There's just no way we're not gonna lose people in this. It's just too big. Come over there. Ah, Sir Steinhardt, good of you to join us. Things are looking very bad, I'm not gonna lie. Get out the long axe. We're gonna need it. Bertram! Miss. Ooh, he's looking very wounded. Those arbalests are gonna be a goddamn nightmare. Right, fire fan. Good. That ought to make them feel how they should about this war. Like an impending defeat. Very nice, he gets to act in 48 turns. Oh, yeah, sure, you just magically lob an arrow, sure. Oh god, he face tanks that one. He just gets murdered by arbalests in return, so that's good. You know, our arbalests aren't useless, which is nice. They provide useful support, at least. Yeah, you should not be alive for much longer. You don't have the sort of hit points to keep face tanking that forever. That does give Firefan extra reach advantage as well. Quite frankly, they should be dying. Very quickly. He does get a reach, he gets overwhelmed, but it's not gonna be good enough. Roderick's gonna have to take care of him. Did you just rally? I think you just rallied. Fair enough. It's a smart choice. We cannot put a stop to that yet. I'm gonna move you over here, BBS. Into cover from all other rangers. He dies from blood loss, that's a shame. Not much we could have done about it, though. Let's try and win the southern flank quickly. There we go. One billman down. That's very good. I approve. Take the 34, get the kill! He gets another kill as well, they're down to 19 men. Oh god. Gerhard. That's a 43, we can try that. Or a 60. Well, that's simple. Sir Eckhart's over there. He's next to Super Sarge. That's a bit of a problem. Yeah, you rest. I'm not sure that's helping, but okay. Ow. Don't do that again, please. I need those extremities attached. I don't think that helped. I mean, we'll try. I mean, he's a priority target right now. Obviously, I can't pull back Firefan or anyone, but I will be diverting resources to that. Rather quickly. If possible. They rally, which is not all useful to me right now. just gonna go for a single hit here. And murder! Which does help. Hey, roly-polies, that's fine. We need to fall back and, like, start working on him. As for you, trying to hit him. Oh, come on. He's gonna move on over there, slowly. Yeah, let's overwhelm him. Oh, guess we just got some reinforcements to deal with Sir Braveheart over there. There we go. Roderick's gonna be able to start overwhelming him. Still, Bertram is not in a good position there. He's gonna die if he stays there for too long. That's it, we do have a significant numerical advantage over them for now. I don't know how long that will stay, but it's working for now. And the southern flank is looking very shaky there. 63, 83. Well, that's quite simple then. 45, 46. Oh, we can start overwhelming Sir Eckert as well. Alright then, this is a proper fight now. So far, our men have been doing surprisingly well. Oh, I don't think our side has lost a single dude yet. I mean, that might turn around really quickly, though. That doesn't help. I need Supersarge out of here, ideally. I'll switch around with you, try and get him to the back slightly. I'm not sorry! I'm really not. Oh, that's a good hit there, nice. Arbalesters, take them down, quickly! Wow, I'm amazed you managed to hit that shot in the shield at all. Instead of firing in my back. Ow. Yeah, Balon, that's a sign of withdrawal. Fire fan misses. Ugh. He rallies his troops, that's fair enough. BBS. Try and put down that Arbalester. Start overwhelming him. Simple. Oh, that is a mercenary, okay. I was just thinking, you know. It was good, so I don't know, maybe he wasn't. Yeah, Steiner, get in there. We need to kill that Billman. We need to turn our victory in the south into a total victory. Quickly, too. We're still doing quite alright, actually. Let's try and keep putting him down. Balon. He's definitely in trouble there. Trying to kill him. Good lord! He's got a perfect defense going on! Right, well, this is not going that badly yet. We're holding our ground. The enemy has taken heavy losses. Right. See you, Balon! You have my permission to withdraw, even though you won't. Nicely done, Sir Steinhardt. That kill is valuable to us. I'm pretty sure Balon's gonna be safe, which is good. I don't like deaths. They're expensive. Ooh, nice! Nice! Arbalesters are going down, left, right, and center. Let's hold Supersarge here for now. Yeah, I'm not gonna switch you to the bow. Actually, screw that! You get to hit a shield. Enjoy. He is exhausted, which is really good for us. Firefan is not lucky, sadly. Also, I just want to point out that Standard Bearer has been surprisingly healthy. When I thought he would have been dead. Good lord, BVS. You're using a crossbow. You're just not accurate at all. In the least. This is a massacre. Good lord. Keep putting him down. I mean, granted, all of our troops are starting to take tremendous casualties at this, or at least tremendous damage at this point. But none of it has been so overwhelming to the point where we've started taking losses yet, which is really good. Let's see if we can put him down finally. That would definitely help us. Firefan is taking some minor wounds. That is a brave footman. Who knows? He's starting to get very overwhelmed and exhausted. Minus 40% right there. Let's see. If Balon's gonna be alive, I'll have you join him there. He's not gonna get sniped by a random arbalester. Good. Well done, Sir Steinhardt. He's just too exhausted to do anything. Take a minor hit. It's fine. I'm gonna start focusing down Sir Eckhart over there. Nicely done. Very good. Let's switch you back now, Super Sarge. Too exhausted, okay. There we go, well done, Firefan. Reload, and put one over there, if you can, which you can't. They're starting to lose faith, which is just as well, because there's only 9 of them left. You know, down you go, man. Taste the mortal coil. Excellent. I would like his hat. Get a good hat. He is so overwhelmed, he's a plus 5 right now, so there's 50% of his melee skill gone. 70%! I mean, also range skill, but you know. His shield's also starting to crumble. Coincidentally. Yeah, they're all trying to hog the glory now. I think that's their only commander. Or knight, or whatever. He's just trying to keep that shield up. Desperately. Yeah, it would have been useful. Oh, looks like we might get the kill on him. There's gonna be one hell of a fat loot pot at the end of this. He's running. You had better run. Tell you to end it for now. And get some pokes into him. Let's see, can we get anyone? I mean, we might be able to get the Standard Bearer with Firefan, if we're lucky. I just need Sir Eckhart to die. Come on! There we go! Excellent. Achievement unlocked! A Knight's Tale. Oh, excellent. There's 5 of them left. Their back is broken. We somehow got out of that without a single casualty. Very weird. I'm not complaining, don't get me wrong. I think we did our share for this battle. Although I really feel like it didn't pay me enough. I will be honest. For all the amounts of fighting you've had me do, 3,400 is terrible. There we go. Well done, Firefan. I can't wait to see the post-battle stats. Nice! It's a good hit. They're not gonna give us the kill, but you know. It's the principle that matters. Ooh, a nice crossbow. Would love to take it from you, but oh well. He's getting very overwhelmed there. Doesn't hit an arbalester. Yeah, he's dead. He just doesn't want to admit it yet. Balon, I haven't given you a hound because, well, I didn't think you'd be here, but here we are, aren't we? Oh well. Let's just end this battle. I'm not gonna let them run, of course. That's not how you're supposed to fight a battle here. There we go, good job, sir. Hit pretty good. Don't get a lucky kill there, he's gonna run away. It matters not. We'll try and end him though. Firefan's just covered in blood. To be fair, that was a bloody battle. I'm glad we got out with a bunch of scars and nothing else. Would have been really costly if we had to loot, if we lost like 4 men or something. Anyway, I believe that entitles us to his arming sword at least. You know, we've got ourselves fairly good loot out of this, regardless. Everyone and their mother is going to be chasing that guy down. Poor guy. He's exhausted, surrounded on all sides. Firefan is just itching to murder him. He doesn't surrender, though. To be fair, I don't think he would be allowed to. They'd put him down regardless. Might as well die in battle, I guess. Yeah, we'll hold with Firefan. He's probably gonna get the killing blow in. Because that's just how Firefan works. Oh, looks like they're fairly good at damaging him. Oh, looks like we stole the kill. Congratulations, Firefan. We just got the achievement for having you become a veteran brother. Gerhard's level up as well. Balon's heavily injured. We get ourselves a Deus Vulthelm. We get ourselves a noble sword. Pike, good god, the loot is pitiful compared to my expectations. Have you not seen what a large battle that was? Corpses in piles 5 deep. Vultures plucking morsels from the mounds. Wounded begging for help. Surely, to a stranger's eye, there does not appear to be any winner here. Sir Steinhardt, however, comes over with a wide grin. Ah! If it isn't the sellsword. Wasn't sure if you'd make it. You should get back to your employer and tell him what happened here. Victory! Let's go to Unheim. And then we're going to be ending the episode. It's been a long one. But hey, nobles, right? You find Baron Torhelm von Hedin having an impromptu trial for one of his commanders. You're not sure what it is over, but the commander's chin is high in defiance. When it's over, he's roughed up and taken outside. Baron Torhelm beckons you to him. Thank you, mercenary. Victory is ours, and I'm not sure that could have been the case without your help. Of course, your reward of 3,450 crowns, as agreed upon. That's not a lot of money, though. Not for the work we've done. We'll sell their false shields, and we now have ourselves the most badass helmet ever. I like it. And a noble sword. and a bunch of noble shields as well. Sell the damage bale hook, sure. What else? I think that's it for now. Anyway, the episode has been going on for so long. Thank you all for watching. If you enjoyed it, don't forget to leave a comment or perhaps a like as well. Helps me, helps the channel. Let me know you want to see some more Battle Brothers in the future. Until next time, have a good one, folks.